We have to go back, and then this mammalistic brain, the limbic system, the brain stem, if it is in order once again, we become happy, strong, and healthy.
So it's what you're saying is so interesting, because the breathing techniques you're talking about does increase the epinephrine, which has been shown, and the adrenaline, which has been shown to have an anti-inflammatory effect. So that is able to secrete these anti-inflammatory cytokines that prevent the immune system from going crazy. So in the study where these 12 individuals did your method, I found it very interesting that they were injected with endotoxin, which is, like, by the way, it's something that humans are constantly exposed to small amounts of, because we have it in our gut. And it's a driver of the inflammation. It's a driver of aging. It's a driver of cardiovascular disease. Everything aging relating. All age related diseases.
Look what you
come back to endotoxin.
How big it is.
Yeah, it's a big thing. So it's and so what happened, you know, physiologically, what's happening with the breathing technique specifically, which I'm calling it hyperventilation. It's controlled, but you know, for simplistic reasons, when you hyperventilate, you increase the adrenaline and the epinephrine, and that has a profound effect on anti-inflammatory. And so these individuals that were doing your method versus the control, when they were injected with the endotoxin, their immune response was activated, but immediately they had this anti-inflammatory cytokines coming out and quieting the immune system from not going crazy. And that's why they were not experiencing all the negative effects of when you have your immune system going overactive, it's inflammation.
Yes.
And then you get the pain, you get, you know, nausea and things that you were describing. That didn't happen.
We got so many cases with rheumatic arthritis,
right?
Arthrosis. We are doing, it's going to come, the studies, and the disease of Lyme and the disease of Crohn, colitis, and asthma, all kinds of, and it's all the same cause. And we are now very able to tap into that very direct.
Quickly.
And, but we have to show this scientifically. And I got so many cases of people using medicine for like 20 years and not using them anymore. There's no need anymore in all these autoimmune diseases about the inflammation, the cytokine production and all that. They control it. They control the pain. They control all the symptoms, and they don't need the medicines anymore. And we want to prove this by science, because I think there is a big industry behind who wants us to take medicine.